Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to start with our class 9 physics topic velocity. Yesterday we have done the topic speed. So similar to speed, we are going to start the velocity. What is velocity? Velocity is displacement per unit time. Yesterday we have done speed. There it is distance per unit time. Now, what is difference between displacement and distance? We have already done. If the path covered by the body from point A to B in a straight path, then it is displacement. If it covers the distance, then it means path is followed, is not proper or in any direction. So, if we consider displacement per unit time, then we are talking about velocity. So as the velocity, displacement is a vector quantity, it is having direction, that is if body is moving A to B, it is defined to a particular direction, so it is a vector quantity. So according to definition, if we want to convert the formula, it will become velocity is equals to displacement over time. From this displacement over time, you can calculate the unit, that is SI unit. Unit of displacement is meter, unit of time is second. So, the unit becomes meter per second. Now, if we talk about velocity, as it is a vector quantity, how we are going to represent it? The representation of the velocity is by the word u or v. If we are talking about u, if we denote the velocity with u, that means initial velocity. Starting velocity of any object is known as initial velocity, and V is used for writing final velocity. If it is not mentioned that it is initial or final, you can use any of these two. So, I have put one arrow above this u or v, that is because of vector quantity. It is an indicator. So, if we read it as u vector, v vector. So, it shows that the quantity is a vector quantity. Now comes to next, that is uniform velocity. What is uniform velocity now? Equal displacement in equal time interval. That is, if a body is moving from point A to B and it is moving in a straight path, but it is having some time intervals. If we put, for example, this is C, D, E, F and G point. If this is 5 kilometer distance and it covers in 5 minutes, same way, next 5 minutes, again next 5 kilometers, in again 5 minutes, 5 kilometers, next 5 minutes, next 5 kilometers, again 5 minutes and next 5 kilometer, 5 minutes and next 5 kilometer. It means a body is from A to B is covering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 30 kilometers in 30 minutes. That is, as we have seen that in intervals, every time the time mentioned and the distance covered by or displacement covered by the body is always same. Hence, we call it as uniform velocity. Now comes to non-uniform velocity. Unequal displacement in equal time interval. If we take the same example, that is from point A to B, now time interval is 5 minutes, but the distance covered is first is 5 kilometer, second is 7 kilometer, third is 10 kilometer and last 5 minute is 6 kilometers. So you can see that 5 minutes time interval is same, But our distance or displacement covered by the body is not same. If this happens, we call the non-uniform velocity. One more cases arise over here when the body is moving in a circular path. If the body is moving in a circular path, but body having the uniform velocity, we call it as non-uniform velocity. For example, the uniform velocity of a body is equals to 5 meter per second. But why we call it as a non-uniform? As we have already talked about that it is a vector quantity, it means here the direction of velocity is changing at every instant of time. If I am talking about this point, if it is moving in anti-clockwise direction like this, the body having direction of velocity at point A in this. If this is a B point, body is having direction this. C point, this direction. And at last, D point, this direction. Or if you have want to calculate at any other point, then also it is having different direction. So, we can't call it as a uniform. We have to tell that it is a non-uniform velocity as the direction is changing. So now come to next, that is instantaneous velocity. As we have already discussed that our speedometers on the vehicle is always telling us about the instantaneous velocity, that is at any instant of time in journey you are going to calculate your speed. You just see the speedometer, that will give you the instantaneous velocity. Here, what is instantaneous velocity? Velocity of a body at any time in journey or at any instant of time is called instantaneous velocity. As I have drawn this diagram over here for non-uniform velocity, similarly, this is the direction of velocity. So, it is representing the direction. And if at any moment of this journey in moving circular path, if any moment you are calculating, here you want to calculate the direction is this, here you want to calculate again the direction is this, here you want to calculate direction is this. So according to the situation, if at any instant of time in your journey you want to calculate your speed velocity, the direction is different, then it means velocity is different. Or at any moment, whatever the velocity is of the vehicle, that is the instantaneous velocity. Now come to average velocity. Average velocity is total displacement over total time taken. Total displacement means if a body is moving from point A to B, A to C, it is having one interval in between from A to B and then B to C. It is covering A to B 10 kilometers, B to C 20 kilometers. Let's say the time taken for moving from A to B is 300 seconds, that is 5 minutes, and from B to C, that is 10 minutes, equals to 600 seconds. What is average velocity over here now? Average velocity is 10 kilometers equals to 10,000 meters. So, I have written 10,000. B to C, that is 20 kilometers, is 20,000 meters. So, it's 20,000 meters. A to B time taken is 300. B to C time taken is 600 seconds. So, I have added over here. Total distance covered by the body is 30,000. And total time taken by the body is 900. If we cancel these two zeros, 3 threes are 9, 300s are 300. So if we divide 100 by 3, it becomes 33.3 meter per second. So this is the average velocity of the given body. Thank you.